So as we did for the previous cases, now let's look at an example. Let's consider a specific use case, maintain curriculum, in which we have the registrar that interacts with the system to do operations for maintaining the curriculum. And let's define the flow of events for this use case. To do this, we're going to go back as usual to the description of our system. So this is the one that you already saw several times, but I would like for you to do something. I would like for you to stop the video, look back at the spec, the one that is shown here, and write on your own what you think is the informal flow of events that characterizes the interaction of the registration manager with the system. And it is very important that you keep in mind something as you're doing that. You should keep in mind that, as it always happens, when extracting requirements from an initial specification, in particular an informal one, like this one, a high-level one, you will have to be able to read between the lines and fill in the blanks. That is, you have to provide information for the missing parts using your domain knowledge. So try to do that exercise. Read the description and see how you will define the steps, the flow of events, for the maintained curriculum use case. If you're done with that, now let's see at the possible informal paragraph that describes that flow of events. And the one I'm providing now is just one possibility, based on my experience and based on the way I see this possible flow of events. So yours might look different, of course. In my case, because the description was mentioning the fact that every user has got a login and a password, I decided that the first step should be that the registrar logs onto the system and enters his or her password. As it normally happens with password-protected systems, if the password is valid, the registrar will get into the system, and the system at this point should ask to specify a semester for which the maintained curriculum activity has to be performed. The registrar will therefore enter the desired semester. The interface that I envisioned is one in which the system will prompt the registrar to select the desired activity, add, delete, review, or quit. And if the registrar selects add, the system will allow the registrar to add a course to the course list for the selected semester. Similarly, if the registrar selects delete, the system will let the registrar delete a course from the course list for the selected semester. And again, similarly, if the registrar selects review, the system will simply display the course information in the course list for the selected semester. And finally, if the registrar selects quit, the system will simply exit, and our use case will end. So again, there's domain knowledge that goes into this, but this is a good example of how you can refine the initial description to identify these scenarios that then you will use to specify and implement your system. And as we discussed a few minutes ago, we provided the information that is requested for a use case, how the use case starts by logging into the system, and how it ends by selecting quit. We described the normal flow of events. And of course, this flow of events could be improved, because right now, even though we describe how the use case starts and ends, we just describe one possible flow of events, but there's many alternative ways we could provide. And we do not describe any exceptional flow of events. So this could be the starting point for multiple use cases, or for a use case that is just richer and contains more information, more steps, so a richer flow. But you should have gotten the idea of what a use case should be.